A warm welcome to the program this week. I am Amarachi Ubani.
Nigeria's President Muhammadu Buhari was in South Africa for a very special bilateral meeting with his South African counterpart Cyril Ramaphosa. This was a very important meeting as it comes weeks after the xenophobic attacks in South Africa, which resulted in hundreds of Nigerians returning home. It was also a very special meeting, as it was the first time in a while both presidents would preside over the Nigeria-South Africa Binational Commission. It is not unusual when presidents meet, but for Nigeria and South Africa, whose relations span over the years as partners and brothers, this would be a special meeting. Special in the sense that the elder brother, Nigeria, would be visiting the younger, South Africa, for 3 days over a rift that resulted in the repatriation of citizens of Nigeria and those of other countries. Mediations had taken place over the previous weeks, but now it was time for presidents to meet face to face.
Mr. President, I'd like to take this opportunity to reiterate South Africa's and our government's deep regret at the incidents of public violence that erupted in some parts of our country a few weeks ago. Some of the acts of violence were directed at foreign nationals, and some of whom coming from your own country. We would like to assure you that South Africa is committed to the ideals of African unity and solidarity, to respect the human rights of others, and to ensure that South Africa is ruled by the rule of law.
Mr. President, we have condemned in the strongest terms attacks against Nigerians and other African nationals living in South Africa, the looting of their shops and businesses, and burning of their properties. We call for the strengthening and implementation of all the necessary measures to prevent the reoccurrence of such action, which threatens to undermine not only our strong bilateral relations, but also what we stand for.
They wasted no time getting down to business. They signed 30 trade and cooperation agreements on Thursday, October 3rd. Among the agreements, the issuing of 10-year visas to businessmen, academics, and frequent travelers. They agreed on early warning signals against possible xenophobic attacks and agreed to share more intelligence and promote stronger partnerships in security. They both agreed to reestablish the Consular Forum, a structured arrangement where both governments meet regularly, at least twice a year, to discuss welfare of citizens. Nigeria's Minister of Foreign Affairs, Mr. Geoffrey Onyema, and the South African Minister of International Relations and Cooperation, Dr. Naledi Pandor, signed the minutes of the 9th session of the Binational Commission. On the final day of his visit, President Buhari attended a town hall meeting with Nigerians in Pretoria, where he encouraged citizens to be good ambassadors, excel, and remember home.
In whatever legitimate engagement you find yourself, you must strive to excel and be the best. Third, while you are out in diaspora, do not forget home. You represent some of the best human assets that Nigeria has.
And as President Buhari made his way back to Nigeria, Nigerians in South Africa feel assured relations with their hosts will be a lot better than it has always been.